for a new video. Today we're gonna show you something. I was frustrated after finding that my Ubuntu could not access, the www directory, the var directory, and when I close here, I can only see things on desktop. If I click home, I don't see that anyway. So since I don't see that, I'm frustrated. You know, I'm doing development, so I want to go to my www directory to go to pick up some files. Yes, I can access files by going to a text editor. Then I click here, then I can navigate to whatever file I need. But now, that's not the issue. The case is, in case I want to copy and paste some files. So look, I can't see that www directory, the var directory, the etc, you know. But in command prompt, I can do that. I can see due to those things to show you that that is possible. But now I want by graphic user interface. So I'm going to set terminal. And I say cd to var. Gonna say cd to var. Enter. You can see I'm there. This is the directory I want. Then ls. I wanna list what is there. So I want to go to this folder www. So I'm gonna say cd to www. Enter. Then cd to html inside there. Then ls. What is an html? Then I want to go to one of these folders. I want to go to my school. I want to go to my school. Let me see. CD to my school. My school. Okay. LS. What is in my school? Then all of this. So I want to. It's a too much. Using commands, and yet you have a chance to use what they call the graphical user interface. So well, let me show you a quick way. The reason why you're seeing that is because you switched off what they call show sidebars. Click here, then click select that. Once you select that, you can see that all your stuff came back, and you can click here, location, computer, go to that, then I go to HTML. I can go to my school, then I see the folders and do whatever I want, right? Okay, you learned now how to do that, but what caused it? The problem is something which is easier to know. This, when you go back here, there's times when I wanted to do what they call show hidden files. When I showed hidden files, look. Then somehow, someone, I think maybe I clicked on that without knowing. So once you click on show sidebars, it will show. If I click on show, you see, that's the way you switch them off. So, but the conflict came, I think, the time I tried to show hidden files. Look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. When I say hidden file, you can see even things which I'm not supposed to do. So you can see all these folders. You're not even supposed to see some of them. But if you don't want to see them, then you can go back and take them out. Then you can see that it can show you only your sidebars. So if you want to take out that, it's okay. But now if you click in here, you won't access what you want to access. So what you do is go back and click that. Then you're gonna see, well, that is that's it. Unless if you want something else, I'm sure that was one of your frustrations. I managed to show you. But anyway, if that does not work for you, try and use a command prompt as I've showed you. Just if you remember the folder, you can just go to terminal and remind you, sometimes you cannot access any folder until when you put in sudo. Just say sudo, then su. It will ask you for the password, but me, I took out that function whereby it has to ask me for the password. They don't ask me for a password, I go in straight. Then you cd2, I want var. Then after var, you say www. After www, then you say html. Oh wow, there's no directory like that. So I think I'm editing the wrong way. html. www. No, there's nothing like that. I say cd to var. Okay. var. You see, that is there, but why there's no www? Oh, I understand. Let me go cd. Going back, I'm gonna recall this command. It was ht. Yes. It has to be www, then stroke html. Look what I did here. The first one I just did html instead of saying html. Then I said okay, then I can list now what I want. ls is for listing, so I can see whatever in here. So now if I want to access any file or folder here, I can do that. So now you can see what I can see. I believe there was a folder I wanted called my school. You can copy that, and if you cd when you're inside that, you don't put that forward slash, you just cd on it like that, because it's in its root folder. So when you in root in that folder, we just don't put the forward slash, you go there. So if I do this and I cd back, then I recall the command and I'm in. Then I say cd to my school. It won't work. They say there's no directory like that, but there is a directory like this. But the problem is that you put a forward slash. The first time to go to those folders, you have to put, but then when you into that folder, you don't have to put. So in case you want to go to my school, and in my school there's a folder, that's when you can say like my school. You can say cd space my school. Then in my school, if there's a folder, then you can do that, because you're not in my school. So you can put that, then you can see that folder. You get me? Let me see t if there is t. Okay, you can do that. I don't know what is in my school. Let me go there. Just ls. See, there's a lot of things in here. So, but now you've seen how it works. So, and if you want to do a folder, let me see which folder can I go to show you. Okay, I wanna do this. Okay, I wanna get to that file. I'm in my school, so I wanna view that file. Let me see some folders. Okay, then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna save vi to that file. Then I'm opening that file. You can see now I'm inside this file. I can change it as much as I need. You get me? So by using command prompt, I'm giving you just a second option, since if what I gave you did not work in the first 4 minutes we started in. But if it did work, there's no need for you to use command prompt. So here, this file, you can edit it if you know vi, but if you don't know vi, I don't know what you're gonna do. You can change anything here. Yeah guys, please don't forget to subscribe, and if I made some mistakes, please correct us. If the tutorial is good for you, please don't also forget to subscribe, and put a comment in the comment box below. See you in the next video, guys, and please share our content.